A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 27th August, on the front page you have PM rejects scope for third-party mediation in Kashmir. So President Donald Trump again discussed issue with Modi on India-Pakistan, but Prime Minister Modi said that the two countries can resolve their differences on their own. Then this is RBI showers 1.76 lakh crore bonanza on government. So record surplus transfer is going to take place from RBI. RBI at its board meeting has decided to transfer 1.76 lakh crore to the central government. And an interim dividend of 28,000 crore will be paid in February 2020. So this is going to help the government in its precarious fiscal situation. So we had seen earlier under former RBI Governor Urjit Patel, the RBI had refused to have huge surplus transferred to the government, and now under the new governor, which has been appointed, Mr. Shaktikant Das, record surplus has been transferred to the central government. So this is shown over the years. So, you know, surplus given to the center. From 2013 to 2017, it has been 50,000 crore or so, and this is now 1.76 lakh crores. Then below you have Manmohan continues to have Z plus security. So you can see that earlier it has been in news yesterday that SPG security has been withdrawn from former Prime Minister Manmohan Singh, but it is said that he'll continue to have Z plus security. CRPF, Central Reserve Police Force, is likely to take over his protection. But then when SPG has the mandate to look into former Prime Minister's security, why should it be withdrawn and why another Z plus security should be given is a question. And this is Congress looks to fulfill poll promise in Chhattisgarh. So Congress has promised Nyutyam Aay Yojana, or a minimum income guarantee scheme, and it was part of the Congress manifesto in 2019 Lok Sabha elections. So now it is looking at implementing it in Chhattisgarh. On page 9, you have the continuation of the front page news. Congress looks to fulfill poll promise in Chhattisgarh, that is NYAY, Nyutyam Aay Yojana. So it will provide 72,000 rupees to 20% poorest families in the state. Then below you have plea in Supreme Court seeks online RTI portals in states. So only Maharashtra and Delhi have set up systems for e-filing of RTI applications. But the petition here asks for all states to provide such online RTI portals. So it is a petition in the Supreme Court on the matter. And below you have Tamil Nadu's first public electric bus ferries passengers in Chennai. So this is the electric bus which has been inaugurated here. It can run a maximum of 40 kilometer with fully charged battery. And below is Chandrayaan 2 scans Mitra crater. So this is Chandrayaan 2's orbiter, or the mother spacecraft, that has zeroed in on a crater on the moon named after 20th century acclaimed radio physicist Sisir Kumar Mitra. So this is the crater here. So images have been sent of this crater by the Chandrayaan 2 orbiter. So then there will be a lander which would be landing, you know, on September 7, lander called Vikram and the rover called Pragyan, which would come out from the lander and move on the moon's surface. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Gold Winner. So this is regarding PV Sindhu. She won at the Badminton World Championship. And it is said she is on the course of becoming India's greatest woman athlete ever. And below you have Earth's burning lungs. So this is regarding Brazil. The Amazon rainforests have caught fire. We have seen it is the largest of its kind blaze which is being seen now. And Brazil's attitude to the destruction of large areas of Amazon rainforest is worrying. So the Brazilian president, his attitude is in question here. This fire is being lit purposely by humans, mainly by loggers and farmers seeking more land pastures. So this is being encouraged by the present Brazilian government. So that is called a concern. It's Mr. Bolsonaro who has assumed power in Brazil. The lead article, time to strike the gavel. So this is regarding how the judiciary needs to dispel the perception that its standing as the guardian of the constitutional rights is faltering. So this is regarding various cases in which the Supreme Court judgment, has been dicey. So that is the question being put forth here. And below you have giving wings to better air connectivity. So this is regarding how cooperative federalism framework can provide the required impetus to civil aviation sector. So air connectivity has been provided. Government has already initiated schemes on this, like Udaan, Ude Desh Ka Aam Nagrik scheme. So the state governments have to work together. So that is what cooperative federalism framework speaks of, cooperation of state governments with the center, and civil aviation sector can be given a boost. Then this is India's culture of toxic masculinity. So this is regarding violent masculinity, which is oppressive, exacerbates social conflict, and is incompatible with democracy, which is being seen in India. And this is a judicial overreach into matters of regulation. So PIL on Aadhaar sheds light on some problematic trends. So this is the PIL which had made front page news about Aadhaar being linked to social media, as the central government is demanding, and various high courts are looking into the matter, and the case has reached the Supreme Court, and it has been said the Supreme Court alone should decide on the matter, so that state high courts don't give conflicting judgments. So the center should be transferred all such cases, was the demand being made by social media platforms as such. Then this is talking trade with the EU. So this is regarding India-EU trade relations. A free trade agreement has been negotiated, and we need to hasten talks with the European Union on this, is what this article says. On page 12, you have 22 tax officials sacked for graft. So, 9 of them were posted as sector officers at a tobacco company in Indore. So, these officers have been sacked. They have been ordered compulsory retirement on charges of corruption and other offences. So, the Central Board of Indirect Taxes and Customs, which has called for their compulsory retirement. Then, below you have 10 declared foreigners released from Assam camp. So, these are 10 persons, including a woman, who have completed more than 3 years in detention center after being declared as foreigners. So Assam government has conditionally released them. So they have been released from the Golpara center in Western Assam, which is one of the 6 detention centers in the state for housing people declared foreigners. There are around 100 foreigners tribunals which have the power to declare or to give a verdict on foreigners. And now 10 of them have been released. 5 of them are Hindus, 5 are Muslims, and all are of Bengal origin. You can see here the border organization is a wing of the Assam police that is tasked with detecting and deporting illegal migrants or foreigners. So illegal migrants or foreigners who are declared so are put in detention centers, and they have to be deported to the country of the origin. So that is the task of the border organization. But presently these have been released within the state. On page 13, you have PM highlights war on single-use plastic. So this is regarding the G7 summit, which took place. And at this summit, Prime Minister Narendra Modi spoke of conserving water, harnessing solar energy, and protecting flora and fauna, along with a war on single-use plastic. On international page, you have signs of hope as Trump says US-China trade talks are on. So China has called and said, let's get back to the table, is what US President Donald Trump said. And these are signs of hope that US-China trade talks are on. And this is hundreds of new fires flare up in Amazon. So this is regarding the Amazon rainforests. And here in Brazil, now hundreds of new fires have flared up. So data shows that even as the military aircraft is dumping water over hard-hit areas, and G7 nations, the summit is going on in France, have pledged to help combat the blazes, more fires, hundreds of new fires have been seen flaring up. It's a huge cause of concern. And below you have, Britain must pay divorce bill even if there's no deal. So European Union has said now that Britain must pay its Brexit divorce bill even if it crashes out of the bloc without a deal. On business page you have cyclical structural issues will take time to fade away analysis. So this is regarding how more jobs losses may be curbed. That's what the Minister of Finance has announced, that revival of the economy will take some time because cyclical structural issues will take time to fade away. So she says that the announcements which the finance ministry made have improved sentiments and they might augment liquidity in the system, but it will take time. So we had seen how some changes were announced by the finance ministry. The taxation on high net worth individuals, which was a cause of concern for FPIs, that had been revoked, and some similar announcements were made. And this is rupee breaches 72 a dollar mark. So rupee has crashed about 59 paise to hit 72.25 intraday, after some of the major currencies including Chinese yuan suddenly weakened against the dollar. And here you have exchange rate driven by capital flows, says RBI. So RBI deputy governor says India's forex reserves are borrowed and not built out of export surplus. So exchange rate is driven by capital flows. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asha.com. Thank you.